Okay, oh, we're hooked up again here. Oh, a little bit of a jump there. There he goes, headed out across. Oh, getting me down into the backing again. Boy. For those of you that missed my introduction to fly fishing, which is an earlier video that I did, these fish are very fond of woolly boogers out here. They prefer black, olive, and of course the brown and tan colors. He's going to come back and visit me here. Oh, didn't like the way I looked. Decided he was taking off for other parts. And they prefer the hairier ones. Ones that have more hackle on them. So if you're buying them, pick the ones that look hairier and have more hackle on them. And if you're tying them, tie them a little tighter. Oh, he's got a visitor with him there. Trying to take that woolly booger away from him. The other one could see where that woolly booger was in the side of his face and wanted to take it from him. All right, come to me, guy. Beautiful North Florida pink. And he is unhooked and he is headed out of here. Successful release. He's out here for someone else to catch, or maybe me the next time I come out. Of course, I have seen them swim out of here and almost immediately turn around and start feeding again. Guess it depends on how badly they're stressed when you let them go. Probably the best weight rod out here, 6 weight, 7 weight, 8 weight. Stresses him a little more, a little less. You still get drag pull out of it. This outfit I'm using right now is a 7 weight. You still get some good pulls out of them. Still get drag pull. They'll still take you into the backing if you're not careful. But generally, you're gonna woo a nice jump out there. Generally, you're going to put your bead head or cone head woolly booger on and give it at least a good 6,000 count to get it down in the water column a little bit. They will occasionally pick it up on the retrieve. One of the keys is to keep just a little bit of slack, not much, just a little, and watch it. See that line jump a little bit? Or pull it. These fish are very good at just kissing that thing a little bit. Then they'll turn around and spit it right back out again. So if you're not careful, you'll definitely miss them out here. Really a nice afternoon out here. Got a late start today trying to get the honeydew list done. Trying to get my sinuses a little under control. They've had me under the weather a little bit this last week. Which is why you'll hear me sniffling quite a bit. But I did want to, while I can, do some introduction to the trout fishing out here for some of the guys that have been asking me, just what are you doing to catch them out here? So I figured I would share some of the tips and tricks with them. One of these days when I'm not actually out here fishing, I'll do a tips and tricks segment. on the best knots to tie, and maybe even how to tie some of these flies out here that we're using. Though woolly boogers are a pretty easy fly to tie. Lots of minnows out here today in this area. I guess the water's up, and being up about 2 foot, it looks like it's 2 foot up the bank here. I guess it's displaced a lot of minnows out here. These fish seem to generally cruise along the drop-offs and look toward the shoreline, or look up. And as they see the minnows and bugs and the debris floating, they see something they like, they'll come up and take a shot at it. Got him. Man, he came in. Ooh, came off. Lost, caught him close in and lost him close in. All right, we'll take a minute's break in here.